I'm Valante, and this is the Sanctuary Sunday School. Thank you so much for joining me. This week's subject is reaping God's justice, and you can find that text in the book of Luke in the 16th chapter. This is the story of Lazarus and the rich man. Now, we are not quite sure if this is a parable or if this is actually an account of a real life scenario, but at any rate, the message that Jesus is teaching in this story is so powerful and is so relevant today. So first, I'm going to look at Lazarus and the rich man, and we're going to compare and contrast these two men. Okay, they were both men, they were both there, and they were both in the same town. But Lazarus was poor. And not only was he poor, it says that he had sores and that the dogs licked his sores. So it means that he had some kind of medical condition and some kind of infection. And then it says the dogs licked his sores. And then also it says that they laid him at the door of the rich man. So it also indicates that he was not mobile, some kind of maybe he couldn't walk or something like that. So this is Lazarus. This is his lifestyle. And this is what he was dealing with. And of course, he also didn't have any food. Now, let's look at the rich man. The rich man, okay, he had money. He was rich and he had this home. And then the text specifically says that he dined sumptuously. Now, to dine sumptuously means that you are eating very well. You have the finest foods and it's prepared by master chefs, and it's delicious, and also that you have an abundance of food. So now we have Lazarus, and now we have the rich man here in this lesson. And it says that, you know, Lazarus was not asking him to, you know, let me stay with you, or even to come eat at your table with you. None of that. All he wanted was the crumbs from the table. So, you know, if you're eating at a table, inevitably something is going to have to hit the floor. So, you know, just sweep the crumbs out to give Lazarus something to eat. And the story says that the rich man would not give Lazarus anything. And again, I don't know if you've noticed it, but I've noticed a common theme in all of these lessons that speak to caring for each other, sharing with each other, and making sure that each other's okay. And that, so that seems to be something, a very strong theme that we're seeing in this unit. And that is so good, because that is how we should be as Christians. The way that we show our love for Christ is the way that we show love for each other. So we have this man here, and he would not help Lazarus. So as time passed, they both died. The rich man was buried, and Lazarus went to be in Abraham's bosom. Now, when we say Abraham's bosom, as we know, Abraham is the father of the faithful, the father of many nations. And it was through the blessings of Abraham that Israel became such a great country. So to say Abraham's bosom, he's the father. He was their everything, their leader. And it's styled as a place of paradise or heaven. And so this is where Lazarus went when he died. So he no longer had these sores all over him. He no longer had to be licked by dogs, and he no longer had to beg for food. And he was there. He had everything he needed, and he was there with Father Abraham. And so we see that the rich man died as well. And the text says that he went to hell. Now, and while he was there, you know, they say hell is hot. And he asked for permission for Lazarus to just come and dip his finger in some water and just put it on his tongue to cool him down just a little bit. And he wanted Lazarus to show mercy to him, but he was not granted that, because, you know, Abraham reminded him of, wait a minute, when you were on earth, you had all of the stuff, you had everything that you needed, and you wouldn't even give this man a crumb. So now this is your time for reaping that. You're going to reap for not sharing with your brother while you were both alive on earth. And so then he said, well, okay, if he can't come down here and help me, just send him back to earth, because I got five brethren there. Just let him go back and tell them what happened to me so that they don't have to go through the same thing. And then once again, Abraham said to him, well, you know, that's not really going to work, because they have the scripture. They have Abraham, Isaiah, all of these scriptures and all of these prophets. If they are not going to do the right thing and live right, then Lazarus coming back is not going to help them. And so his request was denied. And we see that these two men went to very different places. Now, I do want to stop and I want to point out that Lazarus did not go to heaven just because he was poor. And the rich man did not go to hell just because he was rich. It was their character. There are some rich people who are going to go to heaven, and there are some poor people who are going to go to hell. Jesus taught very strictly about riches and about the love of money, because sometimes money will make you do things, and sometimes people do things to earn money the wrong way. But at the same time, sometimes poor people do things as well. So it's not about the money. It is about the attitude. It is about the willingness to love each other. It is about the willingness to obey the scriptures and do what the Lord has commanded to you. Now, even though the text does not specifically speak to the character of Lazarus and what kind of man that he was, but if he died and ended up in Abraham's bosom, then he must have been a righteous man. Again, it was not simply because he was poor. And I really want to make that clear, because sometimes when we are in lack or we are poor and we don't have money, we kind of think that it gives us a straight shot, or we're entitled to go to heaven because I suffered so much down here on earth. I know that the Lord is going to send me to heaven, but not necessarily. We still, even in poverty, you still have to live right, and we still have to do the right thing. And so that is how Lazarus was able to make it to Abraham's bosom. Now we see this rich man here, and he was in hell, and this was the judgment. And we talk about reaping God's justice. And, you know, when things happen, justice is served. And there's another thing that I want to point out. When after they told him no, you know, he said, well, even if I wanted to help you, even if I wanted to let Lazarus leave Abraham's bosom and go help you and go help your brethren, I can't, because there's a gulf there. And that is something that I wanted to point out, because by us being Christians and by us having the love of God in our lives, we are prone to love people and want to help them. And that's why we tell them and we warn them. But when they wait until it's too late, when they wait until it's time for them to reap God's justice, there is absolutely nothing we can do to help them. That's why we're always fussing at our children. That's why we're always telling people, even at the church, that's why we're always preaching. We need you to get right. We need you to do the right thing, because there is going to come a time when it's going to be too late. And I just want to compare and contrast the wages of sin and evil in the Old Testament and in the New Testament, because in the Old Testament, we see that God was in the prophets and he would pronounce judgment against them. But the judgment was always related to something natural, something that would happen in this world. So in the Old Testament, we see that the consequences centered around what was going to happen in this world. In the New Testament, we see a lot more about what's going to happen in the world to come, what's going to happen when Jesus comes back, about heaven and about hell. And you don't have a lot of what they call fire and brimstone preachers anymore, because nobody really wants to hear that. We just want to hear that God is good. God is going to bless you. This is your season for a miracle. That's all we really want to hear. But God is still requiring righteousness, and there is a wage to sin, and that wage is death. And not just a natural death, but a spiritual death, where you spend eternity burning in hell like this rich man did. And as a Christian, as a woman of God, as a minister of God, or as a teacher, or whatever you want to call me, my goal is not to threaten you and tell you you're going to hell. That's not my goal. My goal is to spread the word of God so that as many people as I can touch do not end up in hell. I want us all to be resting in paradise together with the Lord for an eternity, reaping God's justice. Both of these men spent eternity based on the way that they live. Right now is the time that we determine how we're going to spend eternity. And again, God is just. It is just a matter of making a decision to live right, to do the right thing. I say all the time, just make a commitment that I'm not going to do anything that I can't ask God to bless it. If I can't pray and say, Lord, bless what I'm about to do, don't do it, because it's just not worth it. It is really time. And I'm going to say this again this week. We are living in the last and evil days. This is such a timely lesson about heaven and hell, because heaven is my goal. Nothing on this earth matters. Everything on this earth is going to pass away, like we saw in this story. At the end of the day, yeah, while they lived, you had the rich man way here and you had the poor man down here. But at the end of the day, these men were judged by the same standard of righteousness. And that is what determined how they spent eternity and the way that they lived their lives on earth. That fine house no longer mattered. Those sumptuous meals, they no longer mattered. Those sores all over Lazarus' body, they no longer mattered. Living, laying in that gutter with the dogs looking at him, no longer mattered. The only thing that mattered was the righteousness. And that is what we have to remember. Don't get distracted. Don't be deceived. Don't be fooled by what you see and by people tell you. The only thing that's going to last, only what you do for Christ will last. And that will be what determines what happens to you when it's time for you to reap God's justice.